you're a classically trained actor. You're a classically educated man. You're a scholar of some sort. You went to Cambridge University.
Yes, I did. Yeah.
And you studied classics. That was your focus. What do you do with a classics degree other than like, hey, you want to know about Ovid's Metamorphosis? Because I translated it.
I can tell you about it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Apollo and Daphne.
Yeah. What was your plan?
I didn't know. I think I'd always. I've discovered, strangely, that I was good at it. It was one of the first things at school I found I was good at, you know, terrible at math, terrible at science. And then I started learning Latin declensions, and I was like, I know the answer to that.
Another sure. Pula, pulae, pula.
Right, exactly.
Pula, pulis, yeah.
That's exactly it. And, yeah. And then I actually became really interested in it. I think the stories are so great. I genuinely loved reading the Odyssey and the Iliad and... Plato in the original Greek. It's like reading.
Wow. Hold on. When people read it in not in the original Greek, you go, you're not really getting it.
You just don't get the.
Is it really?
Something in.
Yeah.
No, it's a bit like, I suppose, you know, the French talk about. They wish they could read Shakespeare in they read translations of Shakespeare, and they have to work their English up to a point where they can read Shakespeare in English, and it's a bit like, you know, when you read stuff in Latin and Greek, it's a weird foundation in language. I've always been quite grateful because if there's a word I don't understand, it usually comes from a Latin or Greek root, so I sort of know what it means.
I have heard it described that. Reading a great work of art, not in the original language, reading a translation is like kissing a woman through a veil.
Who wants to do that?
Me, not me.
Not me.